In this video, we will show you how to create a simple XML-to-XML mapping. We will also explain how to combine values into one string and supply the current date and time. When you launch MapForce, a new design is created automatically. Before inserting our components, let's first see the transformation language. For this mapping, we will use XSLT3. For this example, we used XML spy to create schemas and XML files. AuthorsXSD is a source schema that defines the structure of the source file. You can also see an extract from the source file. We will start by adding a source schema. MapForce will suggest choosing between a prepackaged schema and a local or remote file. We will choose a local file. When you add a schema, MapForce will ask you if you would like to supply an instance file. To be able to preview the output, we must supply an instance file for the source component. You can also add an XML file first. If this file has no schema reference, MapForce will suggest creating a schema for you. We will use AuthorsXML. Now the source component is available in the mapping area. Click the plus icon to see the whole tree structure. Drag the corner of the component to adjust its size. Our target component is an XSD schema called Book Catalog. Let's add our target component to the mapping. Using an instance file is not meaningful. If you supply a target instance file, its data will be overwritten by the data map from the source component. Now both our source and target components are available, and we can start mapping source nodes to target nodes. Drag the line from the output connector of the author element in the source component to the input connector of the author element in the target component. You will notice that the nodes with the same names got connected automatically. This is because the Auto Connect of Children option has been switched on. The next step is to combine an author's name and country into one string. To be able to do it, we will use the concat function. Navigate to the string functions in the function library and drag the concat function to the mapping. First, let's connect the author's name with value 1. Then we need to add a comma and a space. In order to do it, we will add a constant. Connect the constant with value 2. The last parameter will be the author's country. The concat function can accept any number of input parameters. To get the third value, connect the country element with the plus icon of the concat function. Finally, connect the result of the function with the author info element in the book catalog. Let's preview the output at this stage. All the author data is alright, and we can go on with our mapping. You will notice that most of the input connectors are orange. This means the nodes are mandatory. Whether nodes are mandatory or optional is defined in the schema. So the next step is to connect the publication element with the book element. Since the child elements have the same names and types, they get connected with one thick line. This makes it much easier to work with the mapping. Let's take a look at the output. Now all the authors and all their books are listed here. The last dot is to indicate when the output file was last updated. We will need the current date time function. Let's take a shortcut to add this function to the mapping. Double-click the mapping area, then start typing current. Then double-click this function. Connect the function to the last updated node. As soon as our mapping is ready, we can preview the final result. When you click the output pane, MapForce automatically checks if the execution of the mapping is successful. You can also explicitly validate the output. By default, the data displayed in the output pane is not saved to a file. To save the output, open the Output pane and click Save Generated Output. You can also preview the code that performs the transformation. For external execution, you can generate code in the selected language and save it to a file. MapForce also allows you to generate code in other languages. You can test all the MapForce features yourself. Simply download a fully featured 30-day free trial from the Altavo website.